Today's hotel transports us to the slopes of Mont Blanc and the Italian region of Valle d'Aosta. Some of you might recognize it from the 1993 survival drama Alive, where it played the role of the fuselage, which crashed into the side of a mountain, killing most passengers immediately and driving the rest to cannibalism. It goes by the name of the Bivacco Gervasutti, and it was named after the famous alpine climber Giusto Gervasutti.
Who died on Mont Blanc.
Despite being out in the arse and middle of nowhere, it's not even that cut off from the rest of society, like Wolverhampton, because it has a solar panel, which powers an internet connection, which means you can check your emails, go on Twitter, or send for urgent help if one of your companions plummets to their death. Unlike the unfortunate survivors of the 1993 classic Alive, guests of the Bivacco Gervasutti can dedicate their waking hours to recreational pursuits, rather than desperately struggling for survival by cannibalizing chunks of co-pilot. You can climb over rivers, you can climb over rocks, you can climb around big rocks, and you can climb up really steep rocks, and you can walk in such a way that kind of respects the social distancing. It wasn't the first structure to be built on this site. It replaced a wooden or Spartan structure built in 1940. Why the f*** would they build another one? One night stay in the Bivacco costs nothing. The owners ask only for a 10 euro donation, although who's going to come and get it, I have no idea. It's probably the poor butler from the Northstone Hotel.